My last guest here at CFS Plus is Bill Foudy. He leads sourcing and development for Target's own brands with a focus on delivering responsible and sustainable products. And I'm particularly curious about how a huge corporation like Target has steered through the COVID crisis and everything else happening in Minneapolis. Hi, Bill. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too, Ava.
And it's great to see you. And I'm, you know, obviously I'm super curious how you have coped with all of this and how Target, as such a big player, has coped with the crisis of the COVID. So can we maybe start there?
For us, is our approach from day one has been a people-first approach. And we literally, you know, sat down in conference rooms to have those conversations about what will be our approach. Is it people? Is it business? What does that look like? And we said, no, it's people. And that's who we are as a company. And so a lot of our focus out of the gates was on ensuring that our team members in the stores were safe, in our distribution centers, and then obviously we were creating the safest shopping environment that we could. We have focused on increasing our minimum wage. So we moved that up to $15 an hour back in July. So yeah, I'd say people first, really kind of focusing on the values and purpose of Target has been our approach to this pandemic.
Last week, you also came out with your corporate responsibility report for 2020. When you look at Target and how Target is sort of valued or assessed, it's you're not focusing only on the Wall Street earnings, so to speak, but also on how you're judged by team, communities, and your guests. So that made me think about the topical theme for CFS Plus, which is redesigning value. And so how do you see this connect?
Redesigning value. It's a big conversation. And, you know, I think there's the typical things that are there for value. And when you think about our guest around quality, their expectations of purchasing product that's made in a responsible way. Obviously, you know, cost is associated with that. But what we're seeing evolve, and you would have read about in that corporate responsibility report, is that it's even beyond that. And so, you know, guests wanting to have visibility to and confidence in how a product was made, the impact it has or didn't have on the environment, on the workers in our supply chain, et cetera. So we're starting to think about value and have been thinking about value much more broadly than those traditional, you know, definitions of just quality and price.
How does sustainability fit into the way you're driving your business right now? And has anything changed in the light of the COVID?
Because when we think about sustainability, the way we define it is certainly on the environmental side, but also on the social side. So we think people, we think planet, and of course we think business, and I don't want to miss that is one of the pillars. But we do think about it in three areas. We set a commitment about 3 years ago to enhance the lives of 3 million workers in our supply chain. Excited to say that through these programs and others, we've actually been able to achieve that and exceed that goal ahead of time this year. So incredibly excited about that. And then in terms of what you're getting to, how this really sort of fits into our ways of working, it really is just that. Our approach at Target is to ensure that sustainability is part of how we do business.
Has this changed your mindset as a leader? Has the time shifted the way you look at things, or, you know, how you perceive what you're thriving for, or what creates value?
Look at the challenges in some lesser developed countries and the need for our business to operate in an ethical and responsible way, I think has become more apparent now than ever. And so it's literally how we operate. It, like I said, it's built into the values and the purpose of this company. But we are more encouraged now to double down our efforts to work collaboratively, to engage with other brands, with other retailers, with other third parties and stakeholders. to continue to push forward these efforts. So I'd say the thing that's changed is that it's brought things more to the forefront and accelerated the need for the work that's going on.
Anything that you're optimistic about?
I'm optimistic about the things that we've learned, the lessons that we've learned throughout 2020, which is, you know, certainly not been an enjoyable one for many reasons. I'm excited about the goals we have in place from a carbon footprint standpoint. So we announced about a year ago our goal, our commitment to lower our carbon footprint as a total company by 30% by 2030, based on a 2017 benchmark or baseline. But even more than that, we took it to a next level, right? So we're looking at scope one and scope two, but we also went to a scope three, which, you know, encourage others to do. And so that's getting into our supply chain. And so we've also got a public commitment out there that we will
have. And how's that going?
It's going well. And that commitment is that we'll have 80% of our suppliers by spend also with science-based targets out over the next few years. And so it's going well. We're certainly out of the gates. I can tell you that we have not we've not reached that goal yet, but I'm excited about the things that we've put in place. I'm excited about following through on those.
Thank you so much, Bill.
Absolutely.